Okay students, now here is the polar coordinates. Okay, what is about the polar coordinates? Now it let P x comma y be a point in the plane. Let P x comma y be a point in the plane. So here is the xy plane, this is the x axis, this is the y axis, so origin. Now let, here is the point P, x comma y, okay. So it is a point P, x comma y in the plane, such that the length of OP is R, length of OP is equal to R, means the distance of point P from the origin is equal to R, and angle XOP is equal to theta. Okay, here length of OP is equal to R and angle XOP is equal to theta. Angle XOP is equal to theta. Okay. So here then the order pair r comma theta are called polar coordinates. Of point P, then r comma theta are called the polar coordinates of point P. What is r? R is the distance of point P from the origin. R is the distance of the point P from the origin. What is theta? Theta is the angle made by OP with the x-axis, with the positive direction of x-axis. XOP is equal to theta. Then that order pair r comma theta, that are called polar coordinates. These are called the polar coordinates of point P. Now here the point O, that is the origin, is called pole. The point O, that is the origin, that is a fixed point in the plane, that point O is called a pole. Okay, O is called pole, that is a fixed point in the plane. Now here we have to draw PM perpendicular to the x-axis. Now draw PM perpendicular to the x-axis. Then distance OM is x and distance PM is y. OM is x and PM is equal to y. So therefore, from this figure, what is cos theta here? Cos theta is equal to, from the figure, what is cos theta? Cos theta is OM upon OP, that is adjacent side divided by the hypotenuse. So that is x upon R. Cos theta is adjacent side divided by the hypotenuse, that is x upon R. And what is sin theta? Sin theta is equal to opposite side divided by the hypotenuse, means PM upon OP. So that is nothing but y upon R. So sin theta is equal to y upon R. Sin theta is opposite side divided by the hypotenuse. So opposite side is PM, that is y. Hypotenuse, that is equal to R. Okay. So here we get x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. Okay, x is equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta. So if you know the values of r and theta, means if we are given the polar coordinates, means if I given the value of r and theta,
then we can find out the value of x and y. So these are the Cartesian coordinates, x comma y. This x comma y, these are the Cartesian coordinates of point P, and r comma theta, these are the polar coordinates. If we are given r and theta, then we can find out the Cartesian coordinate x and y using this relation, x equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. Okay, now from these relations x square plus y square is equal to x square mean square of this term, that will be r square cos square theta plus, if you take the square of y here, what we get? R square sin square theta. Okay, and now here, but taking r square common from the right hand side, we can take r square as common from the right hand side, so therefore that is equal to r square into in bracket, what we get here? Cos square theta plus sin square theta, taking r square common from RHS. Okay, so what we get here? What is cos square theta plus sin square theta? That is 1, and so that is equal to r square, because cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. So it is the value of x square plus y square. So x square plus y square equal to r square. So if we take the square root here, so what is r here? If we taking square root on both sides, if we are taking square root on both sides, so what we get here? R is equal to root of x square plus y square. R is equal to root of x square plus y square. Okay. Now here, from these two relations, y upon x is equal to, what is value of y? R sin theta. Okay. What is the value of x? R cos theta. So here r get cancelled from numerator and denominator. Sin theta upon cos theta, that is equal to tan theta. Okay, sin theta upon cos theta, that is equal to tan theta, and therefore tan theta is equal to y upon x. Tan theta is equal to y upon x here. Tan theta is equal to y upon x. Okay, so from these two relations, r is equal to root of x square plus y square, and tan theta equal to y upon x. If we have given the Cartesian coordinates, then we can find out the polar coordinates. If we are given the values of x and y, then we can find out the values of r and theta. These are the polar coordinates from these two relations. R is equal to root of x square plus y square, and tan theta is equal to y upon x. Okay. If we are given the polar coordinates, means if we are given the value of r and theta, so using these two relations, we can find out the values of x and y, means Cartesian coordinates. X and y are Cartesian coordinates. R comma theta, these are the polar coordinates. If we are given r and theta, we can find out x and y using these two relations, x equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta. And conversely, if we are given the values of x and y, then we can find out the value of r and theta using these relations. R is equal to root of x square plus y square, and tan theta is equal to y upon x. Okay. Okay, now here is the question. Find the Cartesian coordinates of points whose polar coordinates are number 1, 3,90 degree, number 2, 1,180 degree. Find the Cartesian coordinates of points whose polar coordinates are number 1, 3,90 degree, and number 2, 1,180 degree. So here we are given the polar coordinates we have to find out the Cartesian coordinates. Okay, so here is the solution. First, we are given 3, 90 degrees. Means here we are given r is equal to 3 and theta is equal to 90 degrees. R is equal to 3, theta is equal to 90 degrees. We are given the polar coordinates, means that is equal to r comma theta. So therefore r is equal to 3 and theta is equal to 90 degrees. Now we have to find out the Cartesian coordinates. Okay, so therefore we have what is the relation between Cartesian coordinates and polar coordinates? X is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. X is equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta. So here we have to put the value of r and theta. So therefore that is equal to the value of r is 3 cos, the value of theta is 90 degrees. Here y is equal to the value of r is 3 sin of, value of theta is 90 degrees. Okay, so what is cos 90? Cos 90 equal to 0. So therefore x is equal to 0 because cos 90 is 0. And y is equal to 3 into what is sin 90 is 1. Sin 90 degree is 1. And so therefore y is equal to 3. Y is equal to 3. And so therefore the Cartesian coordinates are, therefore Cartesian coordinates of the given point, are x comma y is equal to, Cartesian coordinates of the given point are x comma y, that is equal to 0 comma 3. Okay, so these are the Cartesian coordinates of the point whose polar coordinates are 3 comma 90 degrees. Okay, now number 2, the second question. Here we are given the polar coordinates 1, 80 degrees. So here we are given 1, 180 degrees, that is equal to r comma theta. So therefore r is equal to 1 and theta is equal to 180 degrees. R is equal to 1 and theta is equal to 180 degrees. Now what to write down the relation between Cartesian coordinates and polar coordinates? So we have x is equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta. Okay, so now here we have to put the value of r and theta. We have to put the value of r and theta. So therefore here x is equal to, the value of r is 1 cos 180 degrees. Okay, the value of r is 1 into cos of, value of theta is 180 degrees. Y is equal to r is 1 into sin of, the value of theta is 180 degrees. Okay, so I am putting the value of r 1 and theta 180 degrees. So that is equal to, therefore x is equal to, what is cos 180 degrees? Cos 180 degree is minus 1. Cos of 180 degree is minus 1. Y is equal to, what is sin 180 degree? Sin of 180 degree is equal to 0. From trigonometric table, the value of cos 180 degree is minus 1 and value of sin of 180 degree, that is 0. And therefore required Cartesian coordinates r x comma y, that is equal to minus 1 comma 0. Okay, so that is the required answer.
Okay, student. Now the next question is: find the polar coordinates of points whose Cartesian coordinates are. Find the polar coordinates of points whose Cartesian coordinates are. First 5, 5. Second -1, -1. Third -√3, 1. So now in this sum, we are given the Cartesian coordinates. We have to find out the polar coordinates. Means here we are given the values of x and y. That is the Cartesian coordinates. We have to find out the polar coordinates. Means r, comma theta. Okay. Now, first number one. What is the first point here? 5, 5. Okay. So what is given here? We are given x, y is equal to 5, 5. We are given the Cartesian coordinates, means x, y. So therefore, x is equal to 5 and y is equal to 5. X equal to 5 and y is equal to 5. So let r, theta be the polar coordinates. Be the polar coordinates. Of the given point. Let r, theta be the polar coordinates of the given point. Now, what is the relation between Cartesian coordinates and polar coordinates? X equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta. Now, but here we are given the Cartesian coordinates, we have to find out the values of r and theta. So we know that we have r is equal to, what is r? Root of x square plus y square. R is equal to root of x square plus y square. So that is equal to root of. What is value of x? 5. What is value of y? 5. So we get 5 square plus 5 square. So that is equal to root of 25 plus 25. So that is equal to root of 2 times 25. Okay, or root 50. So it can be written as taking 25 outside the square root. So that will be 5 root 2. So it is the value of r. R is equal to 5 root 2. Okay. And now, and tan theta is equal to, what is tan theta? Y upon x. Tan theta is equal to y upon x. So here, what is value of y? Y equal to 5, x is equal to 5. So therefore, that is equal to 5 upon 5. So therefore, tan theta is equal to 1. Okay. Since 5, 5, this point lies in the first quadrant. This lies in the first quadrant. And therefore, tan theta is equal to 1. That is equal to tan pi by 4. Okay, this point lies in the first quadrant, therefore angle theta is also lies in the first quadrant. Okay, so the value of tan theta equal to 1, angle theta lies in the first quadrant. So what will be the angle? That is pi by 4. The value of tan is 1 for which angle? 45 degree in the first quadrant. So therefore, if you compare both sides here, theta is equal to pi by 4, or that is equal to 45 degree. Okay. And so therefore, the polar coordinates are, therefore, polar coordinates are r, theta, that is equal to, what is value of r? 5 root 2, comma, the value of theta is 45 degree. Okay, so these are the polar coordinates of the point
5,5. Now number 2,
the second point we are given -1, -1. The second point is -1, -1. Number 2, -1, -1. Okay, so here we are given x is equal to -1, y is equal to -1. Here we are given the Cartesian coordinates, means that is equal to x, y. X is equal to -1, y is equal to -1. Okay, now let r, theta be required polar coordinates. Required polar coordinates. Okay, so here, therefore, now we have to find out the polar coordinates, means we have to find out the value of r and theta. Okay, so now r is equal to, we know that r is equal to root of x square plus y square. We have proved that r is equal to root of x square plus y square, root of x square plus y square. Now here, what to put the value of x and y? What is the value of x? -1. What is the value of y? -1. So that is equal to root of, the value of x is -1. The value of y is also -1. And so that is equal to root of -1 square is 1. So that is equal to root 2. So it is the value of r. R is equal to root 2. Okay. Now, here, since the point -1, -1 lies in third quadrant. Okay. Okay. Now see here, tan theta is equal to, what is tan theta? Tan theta is y upon x. The value of y, -1. The value of x is also -1. Y, -1. X, -1. So that is equal to 1. So tan theta is equal to 1. Okay. Now see here, the point -1, -1 lies in the third quadrant. Therefore, theta also lies in the third quadrant. Theta lies in the third quadrant. Okay? See here. So, theta lies in the third quadrant. As theta lies in the third quadrant, so that angle should be greater than 180 degrees. Because that angle lies in the third quadrant. Okay. So here, therefore, tan theta is equal to 1, that is tan of pi by 4. Okay. That is tan 45 degree. But as theta lies in third quadrant, so what will be the value of theta? So tan theta is equal to here tan pi by 4, and that is equal to tan of pi plus pi by 4. Okay, now it is the formula, since tan pi plus x is equal to tan x. Tan of pi plus x is equal to tan x. Okay, what is tan pi plus pi by 4? That is tan of pi by 4. Okay, tan pi plus x is equal to tan x. So what is tan pi plus pi by 4? Is tan of pi by 4. Okay, and so therefore, tan theta is equal to tan of, what is pi plus pi by 4? Pi plus pi by 4 is 5 pi by 4. Taking cross multiplication, 4 pi plus pi upon 4, that is 5 pi by 4. And so therefore, compare both sides. Therefore, theta is equal to 5 pi upon 4. Now, if you convert in the degrees, it is in radians. If you convert in the degrees, 5 pi by 4, that is equal to 225 degree. that is 225 degree. Okay, and so therefore what is r comma theta? R comma theta, what is value of r? R is equal to root 2. R is equal to root 2. And what is the value of theta? 225 degree. The value of theta is 225 degree. So these are the required polar coordinates. R root 2 and theta is 225 degree. Okay. Here tan theta equal to tan co. But tan theta lies in the third quadrant. So that theta should be greater than 180 degree. Okay. Now here is the formula. Tan pi plus x is equal to tan x. Tan pi plus x is equal to tan x. So therefore tan pi plus pi by 4. Pi means 180 degree. Pi by 4 means 45 degree. Means 180 degree plus 45 degree. That is in the third quadrant. According to this formula, tan x can be written as tan pi plus x. So tan pi by 4, that is tan pi plus pi by 4. What is pi plus pi by 4? It is 5 pi by 4 if you take the cross multiplication here. And so comparing both sides, theta is equal to 5 pi upon 4. It is in radians. If we convert in the degrees, that will be 225 degree. Okay. So therefore r comma theta is equal to root 2 comma 225 degrees. Okay. Now here the third is minus root 3 comma 1. But take this example in the next lecture. Okay.